Hi guys, in today's video, we will be checking out Roborock S5 Max Robot Vacuum Cleaner. This is 2-in-1 smart robot vacuum and mop that will help you achieve dust-free floors and sparkling clean tiles, all controlled from your smartphone. This was sent out to me free of charge in exchange for a review, and that's why I'm reviewing it today. I am a stay-at-home mom of 2 kids and I manage my entire household single-handedly. And if a machine like this can free up even a little bit of my time to spend on myself, me time, or to do the things that I love, then this investment is really worth it. And that's what exactly I'll be testing in this video today. It uses sensors to map your home and to create efficient cleaning routes. It offers 3 hours of usage on a single charge. It's easy to use, no supervision needed, even if you have kids around, and you can work freely and the robot will do its job. And there is a mobile app for iOS and Android which allows you to remotely take control of the vacuum or set schedules and other features. To get started, let's do unboxing and quick intro onto the hardware. From there, I will walk you guys through the mobile app, and after that, we will take a look at the vacuum and the installation process. Later in the video, I will test run the vacuum on different surfaces like hardwood, carpets, uneven surface like entering from one zone to another, and give you a review on how effective is this machine in vacuuming. And I'm especially interested to see if it can do a satisfying mopping job, as it would be a game changer for many of us. So let's begin with the unboxing first. So when you first open the packaging for the first time, what you will see on the top is this moisture-proof mat. On the compartment to the left, there is a power cable. In center compartment, there is a mop cloth and a user manual, which is in 5 different languages, and a quick guide on how to connect to Wi-Fi, which is in English. Beneath this, there is a charging dock and the vacuum itself. We're going to have a much more detailed look at the vacuum in a moment, but you can get a quick preview of it here. Now that we have quickly gone over what you can expect in terms of the packaging, let me get this stuff out of the box and I will give you guys a better look at the hardware next. So this is the better look of the docking station. The size is very compact compared to other robot vacuums in the market. This piece of equipment is responsible for 2 things primarily. One, it communicates with the vacuum to help with coordinating position when in use or when returning to home. And second, the silver buttons you see beneath are actually charging contacts. So when the vacuum is running low, it will back itself up to these, which will help vacuum recharge its lithium battery. Now let's take a better look at the vacuum itself. On the face of the vacuum, there is a physical button with 2 function keys in it. This one is used for powering it on or off, and this one is to dock or sending it home. You can press and hold dock key to spot clean. This is the LDS laser ranging sensor that scans the room at a speed of 5 times 360 degrees per second to obtain a high precision map. Now let's take a look under the hood. On the top right, there are 2 LED indicator lights, one for wireless connectivity and other for when you want to reset the system. Beneath that, you can see the removable bin for all of the debris captured during the cleaning process. There is a latch at back to open the bin container, and you can see the air filters on the side and a trash emptying area at the bottom. There is also a brush provided which can be used to clean filters or hair tangled in the main cleaning brush. I think this one is very handy. If you look at the bottom of the vacuum, and this is where most of the underlying functionality of this vacuum is found, in the center, the orange that you see is the main brush which collects all the debris and sends it to the storage. It is easy to open the lid and access the brush for routine cleanup. Next, we have 2 main wheels. If you see the tread on these tires, they are pretty rugged, so I think it will do well navigating to different surfaces. Towards the top, we have navigating wheel for directing movement, and also the side brush for cleaning near the skirtings. Here are the 2 charging contacts located to match the docking station, and last, there are 4 clip sensors which prevents it from dropping from the edges. At the bottom, there is a water tank that stores water for mopping. This has 290 ml water capacity. Also, you can select from the 3K water volume, which in simple terms mean that you can choose required amount of water level, low, medium or high, according to the different floor materials. This is where the mop cloth will be attached. It's easy to click on and off. Press the clips and push in or pull out. To detach the water tank from the vacuum machine, push this orange latch and the water tank will be detached. This is where you will fill the water from. To attach it back, push it till it clicks, same as the mopping cloth. Also on site, there are two sensors. One is wall sensor, which keeps the vacuum position 10 mm away from the wall while cleaning the crevices, and another one is recharge sensor, which signals the vacuum to return home when running low on battery. So in total, there are four sensors that this vacuum use: one recharge sensor, one wall sensor on the side of the vacuum, four clip sensors at the bottom, and one laser distance sensor on the top. There are also two air vents on the side of the vacuum. One is used for expelling hot air and the other one is used as an intake for bringing cool air in. Now, so that we've gone through the basics, let me give you guys a walkthrough on the Roborock app for iOS and Android. Then we will also go through the feature demo of the vacuum and the use afterwards. Once you've connected the app to your Wi-Fi, you have full control of it through your smart device using the app. Once you enter your vacuum device, it will take you to the home page where they have an overview of cleaning area covered, battery level and total minutes run, etc. It will also show you the mapping area where you can see the real-time view of cleaning in progress. At bottom, you have shortcuts to send to dock or to clean. Also, you can select one room or multiple rooms from this page itself. When you click on mode settings, you can select the cleaning mode like balance or turbo, and also the water level like low, medium or high based on your flow requirements. There are heaps of other settings as well that you can do from the top right. You can access the vacuum using a joystick or remote control. You can pin your vacuum to a particular spot and vacuum will go straight to that spot for cleaning, and many other features. Controlling options are very impressive. The circle with the little line is tracing the vacuum's real-time movement, so you have an idea of what area was it able to clean and what is left. The software is programmed very intelligently and every little detail is well thought of. The app comes very handy to track or monitor the progress by giving you real-time view, so you know exactly what is your robot doing and where. So that's what this app has to offer, and now let me turn this machine on and you will see the vacuum in action next. So now we will be testing the vacuum and I will show you what issues we faced when we first turned on the robot vacuum. So after the Wi-Fi setup was complete, we got the vacuum connected to the app. This is the page we got to. Here we had two options at the bottom: to dock or to clean. We pressed the clean and the robot instantly started mapping the house. So first time when you run the machine, it will run onto the edges to map your house. However, it looked a little confused as we had started the cleaning session from a random spot and not from the dock. So I suggest to dock it first and then from the docking station start your first cleaning session. And after we did that, I was amazed how intelligently this vacuum mapped entire house. It was super organized. It mapped boundaries first, then it cleaned in S pattern within the boundaries before moving on to another room. S5 Max understands your home's layout. Its laser rangefinder spins at 300 RPM, sending 360-degree area scans through a custom algorithm in real time. Using that data, it creates a 98% accurate floor plan map, and it knows where rooms are. With that, you can schedule cleans for one room, many rooms, or your whole home with a few easy taps on your phone. I was surprised that it could even enter confined spaces like under the sofa, even though we had a rug close to it. The vacuum also easily entered our room through this raised surface. It maneuvered easily by raising itself up and go over without any issue. I was very happy to see the fantastic job it did under the bed, though I feel I could have turned on the turbo mode under the bed as it was very dusty, as of course these are the areas which are hard to get to with handheld vacuums, areas that we would only occasionally deep clean, but with Roborock you can have every corner of your house clean as part of your daily routine cleaning. It was really so satisfying to see that it rotates around an obstacle and cleans all the edges. Never miss any area to clean. Also, you can press the hold and dock button to spot clean a particular area, and the vacuum will keep on rotating and turn around in that area until it's done cleaning that spot. Quite smart. When it came to cleaning near the skirtings, the side brush did a great job by getting into those crevices. The vacuum also was super accurate in terms of positioning and knew exactly when to turn. We started our first sweeping session without fully recharging its battery, so when the Roborock was low with the battery, it auto-homed itself. Not only that, but this vacuum intelligently calculated the required power for resuming sweeping and resumed sweeping after recharging enough power and then fully charged itself after finishing the cleaning. We tested the vacuum on tiles as well as on the carpet, and I can tell you the performance was same on hard and soft floor. It was not slower or weaker on the rug compared to tiles. So I think it's suitable in both kinds of environments. However, we did observe that it got stuck in dining room as it was trying to get underneath the chairs and clean, but we decided to flag this area as no-go zone as it wasted a lot of battery recharge trying to get into those little spaces and doing nothing. We flagged laundry and our storeroom as no vacuum zone as well, as these are filled with stuff and I do not want Robo to enter these rooms and get stuck. When you're done cleaning and you're ready to call it home, you can do so through the app, or when it runs out of battery, it should auto-home itself to the docking station. It's going to slowly wiggle itself to those charging contacts. Once it has stopped and self-charging, you can open the lid and empty the dustbin, dump it out and refill it for the next time. So that's it guys from my demo on Roborock vacuum in action, and now let's see the mopping function, which I'm most excited about. Before we check out the mop function, let me tell you guys that this vacuum is S5 Max, and there is already a S5 version in the market whose mop function was not as powerful, and hence the company has added many advanced features to this version and made it powerful mopper, and let's find out if it can meet the expectations in this area. First, let's fill the water tank with plain water. Do not use any disinfectant or hot water, just plain tap water. Now install the mop cloth. You can dampen the mopping cloth and squeeze it dry before attaching it if you want to speed up the mopping process. Also use a barrier tape or no mop zone to prevent mopping on carpeted floors. Slide the mop cloth bracket under the water tank following the alignment marks until you hear a click. Use the mobile app to adjust the water flow to suit your flow type, low flow on stone, high flow for grimy kitchens, etc. Now press the start button or use the app to start cleaning. Once started, the robot will plan its cleaning route based on its scan of the area. It cleans along the edges of the zone first and then moves in a Z-shaped cleaning route to cover the internal areas efficiently and thoroughly. It covers all areas and does not miss any. Also, its huge 290 ml water tank is enough to clean a 700 square feet apartment more than 3 times, or a 2600 square feet home in just one go. Now all you need to do to mop every day is fill up the tank and set a schedule. Now so that we have taken a detailed look at the sweeping and the mopping function, let me wrap this up and I will give you my final thoughts. I'm a cleaning enthusiast and I've always been obsessed with stick vacuums, but I have to be physically doing the job with stick vacuums. But with the Robo vacuum, I can sit and relax with my family while the Robo is doing its job, and that is such a game changer for me. Regarding the setup, it was super simple and pretty straightforward. Configuration to the mobile app was set up like a wizard. It holds your hand each step of the way. When it comes to the access of the vacuum's main feature, they have set up shortcuts to get things moving from the main screen. I really like that you can schedule the cleaning session. Mine is set up at 8 PM every night after dinner, which was actually my time to do the vacuum post dinner. But now I can sit and spend time with my family, and I love the fact that this machine could free up my time. This is like my personal house help that doesn't even need any supervision. I can also do a cleaning run even when I'm not home by remotely accessing through the app, and I can come back to a clean, vacuumed and mopped floor. So guys, that's everything from my side. If you too are looking to buy one of this vacuum, Roborock is offering 10% discount plus $100 gift card plus 30 free disposable mop to the first 500 customers, but for limited time only. Check the description box for more details, and that's it for this video. I hope you find this video helpful, and I shall see you in the next video. Bye for now.